Dad. It's happening.
You need to come home and see your mom. I'm the backup parent, the understudy.
Seeing as our next movie that we're going to review takes place in Hawaii, I busted out my official slash unofficial Magnum PI shirt. Hello there, everybody, and thank you once again for tuning into my favorite website, realscreenreviews.com, and I'm happily joined today by my lovely returning guest critic, Debbie D'Angelo. Thank you for being here.
I really wish you looked like Tom Selleck. I love him.
I guess I could say I wish I looked like Tom Selleck, too, because that would be quite a compliment. Well, thank you for being here. And our next movie review is The Descendants. And The Descendants opened in November or December of 2011, depending where you live and what major city you live in. And it stars George Clooney, Robert Forster, Matthew Lillard, and Shailene Woodley, a newcomer, Shailene Woodley. This film comes to us from writer-director Alexander Payne, who brought us Sideways and one of my favorite films of the 1990s and of all time, Election, with Reese Witherspoon. And without further ado, I will turn it over to my guest critic to tell us a little bit about The Descendants.
Well, in The Descendants, an attorney slash land baron played by George Clooney is trying to reestablish his relationship with his daughters after his wife is seriously injured and rendered comatose after a boating accident. At the same time, and I feel like I really need to mention this, there's like a subplot about some land in Hawaii that has been in his family for generations.
It's the last 25,000 undeveloped acres in Hawaii.
Right.
It's breathtaking.
And,
but go ahead,
and whether or not he should be selling that. And it's supposed to be a joint decision amongst his relatives, but he has the final say.
Yeah, and they're all the descendants of a queen that was in direct relation to King Kamehameha, who's like, you know, the official one lord king of Hawaii. Well,
thank you for that history lesson.
Well, as usual, I'm going to try and guess whether or not my lovely guest critic liked or disliked this movie. And I'm going to say you had to have liked this movie.
I love this movie too.
Just go ahead. Why did you like it?
You know, there were so many things about it. I did read some criticism, some critique saying that there were too many undeveloped plots or subplots. I didn't think that at all.
I didn't think so
either.
There was
a lot going on, but I think it worked. I think they developed it. And George Clooney has to be the master of conveying emotion through facial expression without saying a word. It reminded me, it was reminiscent of The American, which I hated.
Right, but
it was just his performance. And there were the characters, the character development, the growth of the characters,
with the characters, and you said about the loose ends, whatever, I'm going to get right to director Alexander Payne. I think this man is a genius with the pen, and he's a genius with the camera. And he reminds me of the Christopher Nolan of smaller films. Christopher Nolan makes the Batman movies and big, really big, complex movies, but they're storytellers first, and they build usually flawed characters, and then they assemble a movie around these people. I think the characters that they develop in this film, even the smaller, lesser characters like the land developer and his wife that come into play, are real people. These are people that the audience can identify with, and I think that Alexander Payne is a genius. I think that Clooney was the best person to be the lead in this project, and I can't agree with you more when I tell you, you can tell there's a lot going on in this guy's plate. He's just got so much going on, and we are gonna get into a few things here, and we're not giving anything away that isn't in the trailer of the film. His wife has a massive coma, and we then in turn learn that she was having an affair, and once again that was told to us right in the trailer. But that in turn brings out this animosic daughter and her friend Sid, and they were wonderful too, I thought.
I totally enjoyed him, because when he first comes onto the scene,
you think he's the biggest doofus,
you know? But then you learn about his backstory, and your heart goes out to him.
Oh, absolutely.
You totally relate to him, and you understand why.
And you like this kid.
I liked him.
And I'll tell you, here's another good point. How about Robert Forster as the father-in-law?
Oh, yeah.
I love Robert Forster. I think he is one of the most honest actors. I think he makes acting look almost effortless. And he reminds me of anyone's grandfather, or everyone's grandfather. And when he punches Sid, it's like the 70-year-old guy punching the 17-year-old kid, and it was a really fun moment. It was a great movie.
Because
I love
even though it's a drama, there are a lot of comedic overtones.
So absolutely.
There are a lot of funny parts, and I do agree with you. I think there's a lot that's relatable in this movie. Just the infidelity issue.
Absolutely.
From knowing people who have cheated or who've been cheated on, I think it, you know, really hit upon some major issues there. I like the way George Clooney was trying to find out information.
And then
And I like the woman who had been cheated on.
Right, the wife.
The spouse.
Right.
And the family, because sometimes you assume, well, what kind of wife did he have or what kind of family?
And that could have been a throwaway. They both could have been throwaway characters.
Strong.
And they weren't. Every person that's in this movie is very strong. And the scene at the end, there's almost a redemption scene between George Clooney and his wife. And I'm not going to take that any further. But I would actually tell you that, you know, you don't know this wife. You don't even meet her. I mean, you mm-hmm. see her in some flashbacks, but you don't even meet her. She wasn't a perfect person, but you feel sadness for this lady that you've never met. Mm-hmm. And the scene with her and George Clooney near the end of the film could be his best scene as an actor. I thought it was. I thought it was just fantastic.
But you know what? I walked away from this movie thinking, this is very relatable because everybody's had some kind of adversity or tragedy in their life.
Mm-hmm.
And the key everybody's is striving for is to reestablish a sense of normalcy. And what I got from this was, yes, you can establish a sense of normalcy, but it's a different kind of normal. You're not going back to the same normal that you had. And the
Absolutely.
Very last scene where he's sitting on the couch with his two daughters eating the ice cream.
It was great.
To me, that really reflected the fact that they were going to have to move on with their new life in a new sense of normal.
And it's a very heartfelt moment. And and I don't think any dialogue's even spoken there.
No.
And you can just feel this, that they're kind of working things out even without speaking. And another positive in this film, I thought, was, you know, without giving anything away, the decisions that have to be made in reference to them being the descendants of this land and what they're going to do with it. And I thought the way that they went with that was a very realistic ending or conclusion to that storyline. And I think that probably fit this movie well, because I think every part of this movie is a very human and realistic way to be.
But you know what? I didn't really understand why they called it the Descendants until the very end, as I'm thinking about, well, how am I tying this together?
Right.
So it's kind of unusual that the title reflected a minor part
Absolutely.
Of the movie. But then when you start to think about what it meant to him and family and the journey and the growth that he went through, finding out that his wife was cheating and trying to figure out what was a priority in his life and how he was going to get back to a normal life, then I could understand why they called it.
Now, I love movies like Mission Impossible 4 and This Adventures of Tintin. They were both great movies, bigger than life. But in my heart, these are the movies that I love to go and see. When you sit down and you identify with people and you almost feel like you know these people by the time the movie has ended.
Just oddball goofy scenes made me laugh, where he was running down the road to his friend's house in his flip-flops.
Yep.
Just the way he was running, it was funny. But how about his friends who knew the wife was cheating, who knew she wanted to leave him, and didn't say a word.
No, and he was totally bamboozled by this entire thing. And what about Beau Bridges, that shows up as like his cousin or whatever? And really a very cool character. I love Beau Bridges. He shows up like in like 3-4 movies a year and really delivers like a pretty good solid performance almost all the time. He's just, I like watching him. I think he's a really fun actor. Well, Debbie, what is Debbie's real screen review of The Descendants? It's got to be something good.
Oh yeah, I'm going to say 3.5 stars.
3.5 stars. You know what? It's funny. I'm going to be right there. Usually we're not, you know, at, you know, at equal and everything. But this time I'm right there with you, and I'm going to say that Nick's real screen review is definitely 3.5 stars out of 4. This made my top 10 list as definitely honorable mentions, 6 through 10, one of the best films of the year. Do yourself a favor and please go out and see The Descendants.
Highly recommend it.
Highly recommended. So 3.5 stars and 3.5 stars, that's as high as recommendation as you can get. And Debbie, thank you so much for being here at realscreenreviews.com, and we can't wait to have you back. Oh, and she's going to be back, I think, in a few weeks for One for the Money with Catherine Heigl or Heigl.
Oh, I'm just hearing about
this. Yes, she's going to be in for that one, because I have seen the trailers for this one, and I think this movie looks like just a train wreck waiting to happen, but I want a female's opinion on this one. So, but remember, people, until next time, we're not always right, but only when it comes to the movies, and thank you very much for your attention.